गुड डे चिल्ड्रन, साई राम, वेलकम बैक टू अ हिस्ट्री रिविजन. इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव रिवाइज द लेसन्स विच आर देयर फॉर हिस्ट्री सेमेस्टर एग्जाम. ओके, नाउ लेट्स सी व्हाट टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चंस वी आर गोइंग टू गेट रिलेटेड टू हिस्ट्री लेसन्स. जस्ट गो थ्रू दिस क्वेश्चंस. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वील टॉक अबाउट द मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चंस. इन 1453 द सिटी ऑफ डैश वॉज कॉन्कर्ड बाय ऑटोमन टर्क्स. In 1453, the city of Dash was conquered by Ottoman Turks. A. Venice, B. Constantinople, C. Paris. What is the answer? Yes, correct. Constantinople. Next, in 1764, Battle of Dash was fought in Bihar. Plassey, बक्सार, खानदेश. विच बैटल वॉज फॉट? येस, बैटल ऑफ बक्सार. द पिट्स इंडिया एक्ट वॉज पास्ड इन द ईयर डैश. ऑप्शन ए 1764, ऑप्शन बी 1784. येस करेक्ट, इट इज ऑप्शन बी 1784. सो क्लिक ऑन द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. Dash introduced the dual government system in Bengal. Just now in the revision, in the previous lecture, I have revised the lessons. In that, I had told you about this. Dash introduced the dual government system in Bengal. Robert Clive, Lord Cornwallis, Lord Dalhousie. Yes, Robert Clive. Dash established the Brahmo Samaj. Okay, Dash established the Brahmo Samaj. Dr. R.G. Bhandarkar और राजा राम मोहन रॉय. हु एस्टैब्लिश द ब्रह्मो समाज? यस करेक्ट, राजा राम मोहन रॉय एस्टैब्लिश द ब्रह्मो समाज. नेक्स्ट, कंप्लीट द फॉलोइंग. क्रिस्टोफर कोलंबस कंट्रीब्यूशन टू द वर्ल्ड वाज दैट ही रीच द वेस्ट कोस्ट ऑफ इंडिया एट कैलिकट पोर्ट. ही रीच टू द टिप ऑफ साउथ अफ्रीका. He reached at the eastern coast of the American continent. Which option is right? Okay, correct. The third one. That is, he reached at the eastern coast of American continent. Third option is right. Click on the third option. The work of Lord Dalhousie. What is the work of Lord Dalhousie? Pass the Widow Remarriage Act or pass the Sati Prohibition Act? Yes, correct. The first option, that is, pass the Widow Remarriage Act. Okay, so this is how the complete the following will come. Okay, children, let's continue. State true or false. In 1802, Peshwa Bajirao I signed the subsidiary alliance with the British. True or false? Is it Peshwa Bajirao? No. Okay, Peshwa Bajirao II. Peshwa Bajirao I, no. Peshwa Bajirao II had signed the subsidiary alliance. So the statement is wrong. So false. Many orphanages were established through the medium of Arya Samaj. Many orphanages were established through the medium of Arya Samaj. Is it true or false? What was the work of Arya Samaj? To establish education centers or to part with education. Okay? To give more and more education to the people. That was the aim of the Arya Samaj. But here it is given orphanages. So the statement is right or wrong? True or false? Yes, it is false. Lokmanya Tilak started the Home Rule Movement. True or false? In the revision we have done. Who had started the Home Rule Movement? Dr. Annie Besant and Lokmanya Tilak both had started the Home Rule Movement. So, is this answer right or wrong? Yes, it is right. So, it is true. Now, answer in one sentence, we'll see. What is the work of Vishnu Shastri Pandit? Okay. What is the work of Vishnu Shastri Pandit? Religious reformation or widow remarriage? What is the work of Vishnu Shastri Pandit? Yes, the work of Vishnu Shastri Pandit is widow remarriage. He had worked for the emancipation of women. Okay, children? Who were the extremist leaders? Two options are given again over here. You have to choose the correct option. First option is Gopal Krishna Gokhale, Firoz Shah Mehta, Surendranath Banerjee. In the second option, Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Lala Lajpat Rai, Bipin Chandra Pal. Which option is right? Option A or option B? First option or second option? Extremist leaders. Yes, second one. Second option is right. Now, let's see the give reason. Mahatma Phule conducted strike of barbers. Why did Mahatma Phule conduct the strike of barbers? Here are two options given. Yeah? You are going to choose the correct answer or correct reason for this give reason. Okay. First option, along with the spread of English education, there was need of new thoughts, new ideas, new philosophy. Indians were also introduced to Western thoughts and culture. So, is this the option? Or second one, during the expansion of British rule in India, the position of women was very miserable. Child marriage, dowry system, sati, keshwapan, opposition to widow remarriage, such customs prevailed in the society. So which answer is right? Option A or option B? Yes, correct. It is option B. Option B is the right answer. Okay. So, I hope children, you'll have understood what type of questions will come in history. Now, let's go on with our next topic, that is civics. Firstly, we'll revise civics. Yes, let's continue with our civics revision. Okay, we'll revise all the lessons which are there in civics. Okay, for the semester exam. The first, introduction to the parliamentary system. This is the first lesson of civics. In this lesson, we have already learned about the parliamentary system of government. Okay, how the parliamentary system of government started in India. Okay, how parliamentary system of government was introduced into India. Okay, all this we will learn. We have learned in the parliamentary system of government. Then we have also learned about the characteristic of the Indian parliamentary system. Okay, the parliamentary system of government of India, it just looks like the England parliamentary system, but it has many differences in it. Okay, so we have learned what are the differences in the parliamentary system of India. Then, why did India adopt a parliamentary system of government? That also we have learned in this lesson. Okay, can you tell me why India had adopted the parliamentary system of government? Yes, the parliamentary system of government in India is in a way a product of the freedom movement. Okay, it is a product, it was handed over to us. Okay, so during our independence. So we made a lot of changes in that and we accepted that changes. Okay, then discussions, deliberations are an integral part of the parliamentary form of government in India. Okay, for all this reason, we have adopted a parliamentary system of government. Then the presidential system of government. What is presidential system of government? Presidential system of government can be said to be another form system of government. Like the parliamentary system, there is a presidential system of government. Okay. Now, in the presidential system of government, who is the who is the executive over here? The president. The president is the executive in this presidential system of government. Now, features of the presidential system of government. Here in the we have already learnt that the legislature and the executive, they are independent of each other. Okay, that is, legislature works according to their own will. Okay, according to their rules and regulations, while the executives work according to their rules and regulations. Okay, they are independent of each other. but then also they keep a proper watch on each other's work. Okay, that is the features of the presidential system of government. So this is what we have learned in this lesson, introduction to the parliamentary system. Now let's see the next lesson, that is chapter 2, the Indian Parliament. Okay, now in the Indian Parliament, we have learned about the two houses of the Parliament, that is the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. The Lok Sabha is also called as the first house. Okay, it is called as the lower and the first house of the Parliament. Why it is called as the first house of the Parliament? Because here in this house, the members are elected directly by the people. Okay, that is, generally election takes place after every 5 years, and which whatever representatives are elected, they are the part of the Lok Sabha. Then we have learned about the Rajya Sabha. Okay, Rajya Sabha is the second house and also the permanent house of the Parliament. Okay, it is the second house and the permanent house of the Parliament. Then we have learned about the functions of the Parliament. What are the functions? Can you remember some of the functions of the Parliament? Yes, first of all, we can say amendments in the constitution, that is one. Okay, then formulation of laws is there, laws are formulated. Then control over the council of ministers. Okay, all these are the functions of the Parliament. The next thing what we have learned is about the Speaker of Lok Sabha. Okay, after the general election is over, when the members come to the house, the first meeting itself, they select one person as the speaker and the one as the deputy speaker. Okay, so both, what is the work of this speaker and deputy speaker? Their work is to maintain the house. Okay, that means to maintain the prestige of the house. As the Lok Sabha represents the citizen, same way the speaker represents the Lok Sabha. So this is the work of the Speaker of Lok Sabha. Then what is the chairman of Rajya Sabha? We have learned about the chairman of Rajya Sabha. Who is the chairman of Rajya Sabha? The chairman of Rajya Sabha is the ex-officio chairman. Okay, of the that is the vice president is the ex-officio chairman of the Rajya Sabha. Who is the chairman of the Rajya Sabha? The vice president is the ex-officio chairman of the Rajya Sabha. Okay, so his work is also the same as that of the Speaker of Lok Sabha, to look after the house, to maintain the prestige of the house, to arrange for the meetings, to take decisions in the meeting, to help take decisions in the meeting. That is the work of the chairman of Rajya Sabha. Now, the last part is, how does the Parliament make laws? Okay, in this we have learned about the readings. Okay, how does a bill becomes a law? Okay, suppose it is a money bill or an ordinary bill. How the bill becomes a law? By going through a process. That is the first reading, second reading, third reading, and then only it becomes a law by the consent of the president. This is what we have learned in this lesson, the Indian Parliament. Okay, children. So these two lessons are there for your exams, right? Now, let's answer some of the questions. Multiple choice question. In the presidential system, dash is the executive head. In the presidential system, dash is the executive head. Prime Minister, Lok Sabha Speaker, or President? Yes, presidential system means President. Okay, so President is the executive head. Next one. The leader of the majority party becomes the dash. Okay. After the election is over, the leader of the majority party, he becomes the health minister, prime minister, or chief justice. Yes, correct. He becomes the prime minister. So the first option is right. Next one. India's dash is the ex-officio chairman of the Rajya Sabha. Just now we have revised it, right? India's president, vice president, or prime minister. Yes, correct. India's vice president is the ex-officio chairman of the Rajya Sabha. So the second option is right. Answer in one sentence. Okay, here answer in one sentence also, two options will be given. You have to choose the करेक्ट ऑप्शन. व्हाट इज कोएलिशन गवर्नमेंट? यस चिल्ड्रन, व्हाट इज कोएलिशन गवर्नमेंट? डू यू ऑल रिमेंबर व्हाट इज कोएलिशन गवर्नमेंट? यस. ओके, नाउ जस्ट सी द ऑप्शंस, विल रिमेंबर इट. व्हेन नो पार्टी गेट्स मेजॉरिटी, सम पार्टीज कम टुगेदर टू फॉर्म अ मेजॉरिटी टू एस्टैब्लिश द गवर्नमेंट. दैट इज फर्स्ट ऑप्शन. The Prime Minister and the Council of Ministers are responsible to the legislature for all the actions and policies. That is coalition government? No, the first one. First option. When no party gets majority, some parties come together to form a coalition, okay, and establish the government. That is only called as coalition government. Okay, children? Next question. Give reason. Rajya Sabha is a permanent house. Now this is the question. Now I have given two options here also for this question. You have to see which is the right answer. Is the lower and the first house of the Parliament of India? Is the House of Representative directly elected by the people? Okay, this is the first option. Second option is, 1/3 member of the total membership of Rajya Sabha who have completed the tenure of 6 years retire after every 2 years and equal number of members get elected. Because limited members of Rajya Sabha retire step by step, Rajya Sabha can function continuously. Which is the right option? Yes, correct. The second option is the right option. Okay, children. So this is how you are going to get the questions for exam, and you will have the options in front of you, and you have to see the answers properly. Okay, at times I will not give the full answer. I can give 1 or 2 points from the answer, and it will be given as a choice for you. Okay, so be careful and choose the correct option. Okay, children, any doubts now? Okay. Study well, get ready for the exam. Okay, children? Thank you.